The way I see it, there's two types of people. Those who spend their lives trying to build a future, and those who spend their lives trying to rebuild the past. For too long, I've been stuck in between. Hidden in the dark, what was I really doing walking in there with my bad haircut and ridiculous shirt? Was I there to make something right? Or was I just using a messed up situation to indulge myself, grasping at some desperate delusion of control? Maybe the two went hand in hand more than I cared to admit.
Ô papai,
eu vim devolver o seu sorriso favela. Leve e solta pra cantar. Nunca esquecer como sua paz é bela.
I had stumbled into some kind of street party. This was the kind of reality Americans paid top dollar to see. Slums had become tourist attractions, places where yuppies could gawk at the endless spirit of the poor from the inside of their bulletproof buses. I felt dumb and exposed. I missed the booze. Not that it mattered. Sober or drunk, I was hardly undercover. I stood out in this place like a streetwalker in a monastery.
Barracos e morros sem socorro num lugar. Sem esperança, nada, sem luz que possa inspirar.
Continua andando, caralho! Que porra é essa que você tá fazendo aqui? Como que você sai entrando aqui assim? Anda, anda, vai pra lá!
What do you need?
O que você tá fazendo aqui? Eu tô te perguntando! Eu te chamei aqui, porra!
Easy, pal, easy!
Ah, então, você é americano de merda!
Look, I didn't mean any offense.
Me dá só uma razão pra eu não te matar, seu americano burro!
Desculpa, amigo, por favor!
Passa tudo que você tem, viado! Pega o dinheiro dele! Ah, relojão, hein? Passa aqui! Anda logo! Da puta! Valeu, mano! Bem-vindo à favela Nova Esperança! Agora saiu fora daqui!
All things considered, I was gonna have to look on this as a good outcome. I was deep in gang territory. These kids were raised hating clowns like me. Middle-income ass-kickers who protected the rich by shooting kids like them. First day off the sauce, and somehow I'd still ended up in the gutter. If there was one thing I'd learned since I've been here, it was that Brazilians came out of the womb kicking a ball. And for kids like these, was their one legal chance at a ticket out of here.
Tá louco.
Sabe jogar palitinho, rapaz?
Mostra.
Pô, oh, que isso, é a coisa mais simples. Vai lá, mostra pra ele. Você escolhe um dos três palitinhos.
Desculpa, olá. Fala inglês. I'm a little lost, perdido. Onde és tu?
Tá no lugar errado, rapá.
Ah, não compreende. I need a phone, a telephone.
Bora.
Público.
A gente não é centro de informação turística, não.
Well, they weren't gonna help me. And who could blame them? I was a dumb American in a place where dumb Americans were less popular than the clap. If I was gonna find my way out of this mess, I was on my own. It looked like there was a bar up ahead. The irony was not lost on me. I figured sobriety was no use to me dead.
Passa baseado.
Ih, não é tua vez não. Passa aí, meu.
Aí, tem visto a irmã do Wilson, mano?
Aí, ela... O que esse cara quer?
Aí, bela camisa, hein? Tu perdeu o fusão, amigo.
Hey, are you lost?
In more ways than I could possibly explain.
I know you. At the disco, with the gun. Yeah, you had hair back then and... Better clothes. Anders Dedling from Steele, North Dakota. Why on earth are you here?
Well, I'm looking for someone. What are you doing here?
Well, we came to help the cause. See, after I retired, my wife, she said I had to do something. And well, you know, I always loved kids, so I got involved in Angels of the Hill, Oh, it's a great cause, and they're really great folk, and, well, now we come down twice a year to help inoculate the children of the favelas. Yeah, oh, simply wonderful giving back. Whole family does it. Heck, my little girl's coming in a couple of days.
Aren't you afraid?
Ah, I was a cop for 25 years. And granted, Steele ain't San Paolo, but, you know, I seen things. And people are the same everywhere, good, bad, and different.
Listen, have you heard anything about a woman, about 28, rich? She was kidnapped. I heard she was being held around here.
No.
All right, well, good luck.
All right, you too. You look like you need it. I gotta get back at it. Hey, I'll say a prayer for you.
Another life lesson I didn't want.
Oh, sai de cima de mim, meu! Maluco, pô!
I hoped this classy-looking establishment would have a phone so I could call Passos. Either that or a gun so I could shoot myself and save these kids the bother.
Hey, their telephone?
Telefone, vai, lá no fundo, segue em frente.
When you're stuck in a foreign country and you don't know the words for reverse charges, and you're in some lonely skin joint in the middle of some poor slum, having just had every last cent robbed from you, and you call yourself a bodyguard, then you know you're a loser.
Hey, Matt, can I buy you a beer?
Do I know you?
I don't think so.
Look, if you're gonna shoot me, make it quick, I'm a little busy.
If I was going to shoot you, I wouldn't waste a beer.
Wait, come on.
I'm trying to dry out a bit, so just a soda, please.
Sure. Why don't you go sit down?
Guaraná pra ele, um choque pra mim. Bem gelado.
Interesting haircut, by the way. Meant to tell you that.
Yeah, well.
Wilson da Silva. Very good to meet you.
Nice to meet you, I think.
Although you'll forgive me if I promise never to employ you as my bodyguard. You did a great job watching after Rodrigo Branco.
Fuck you.
You were set up.
Bet your ass I was.
Now, let me ask you something. Have you ever seen this guy? Serrano.
Yep. He's a real sweetheart.
Yeah, he sure put his gang out of business. But don't worry, those guys, they're a small fry. This is the guy I'm interested in. Neves. And this is his little buddy here. Milo Hegel. They work for this vigilante group. Crasha Preto.
Yeah, I know him.
Well, they're very popular with right-wing politicians, like Victor Branco. Now, you see, many years ago, he helped clear some villages on a bit of land Rodrigo Branco wanted to develop.
Rodrigo Branco?
Yes, he did some very bad things. Anyway, have you ever seen this guy?
Maybe at the stadium.
I knew you were involved in that business. You know, I wanted to investigate that, but I got an order to blame it on some local street kids instead. Tell me, what happened there?
Nothing. We simply went to hand over some cash to this guy's clowns for a ransom exchange when this guy's clowns jumped us and they shot everybody.
Apart from you and your boy Passos.
That's right. We had to shoot our way out of there.
They let you go. It's okay, it's a little weird right now. But I know that Victor Branco is involved in all this. I just don't know how or why. And I know that the UFE are involved in all this as well, but I just don't know how or why. And you know what's gonna happen? The moment is gonna come along when I put all these pieces together, and at that moment, someone is gonna come along and put a bullet in my head. Anyway, listen. I think you might want this.
Thank you. I'll need it.
And if it's Fabiana Branco you've come looking for, I think she's up the hill.
So why don't you just go get her?
I don't know. I'm a cop. I mean, I'll fight corruption. I'll stand up to the rich and dumb, but if I go up that hill right now, I'll be dead in 3 minutes or less. Maybe you too, Max. You're in the jungle now.
So it appears.
If you survive the next hour, let's speak. You help me. And I'm gonna do what I can to help you. Good luck.
I didn't know what to make of what this guy had just told me. What was true and what was just someone else's convenient bullshit. Then some less than friendly locals came in and found me in the wrong mood to party.
E aí, gringo? O que você tá fazendo aí?
No comprende. Leave me alone.
Você tem alguma coisa pra mim? Do you got something for me?
For you? Tell you what I got. I got a gun, and if anybody thinks they're gonna take it from me, they'd be dead wrong. Running the risk of becoming too clear-headed. Relax, soldier.
You're American? Oh, jeez, buddy. Am I glad to see you? Oh, fuck me. I've been coming to this shithole town for the last 5 years. It's like a fucking insane asylum. But it's got the cheapest pussy in the world. But fuck me. I mean,
you're in a cat house in the slum, pal, doing who knows what.
I'm a businessman, bro. And they were fully legal in this country, I think. And I know how to tip, all right? It ain't my fault, man. It ain't my fault. Don't judge me, all right?
Have a nice day.
Não sei. Tô vendo porra nenhuma.
A gente desce ou não?
Foda-se. Isso aí já era. Não vale a pena, não.
Tá certo. Vamos lá.
The fireworks display was clearly in my honor, making sure everyone knew to roll out the red carpet for their surprise guest. I could hear a woman screaming. I thought I'd found Fabiana, but instead I'd stumbled across some testosterone fest. A bunch of young punks with guns killing time the only way they knew how. Nova Esperanza wasn't exactly a dinner and movie kind of place. I recognized the hoods who jumped me earlier. I was trying to decide whether to crash this party or turn back, when my natural grace and finesse made the decision for me. These bastards looked different, tougher, more capable. They didn't look like Serrano's boys, but I could tell I was moving up the food chain. I hoped Fabiana wasn't going to be served up come feeding time. One vice at a time. There was no need to announce my arrival in that part of town. I'd drawn more than enough attention already. Giovanna, charity worker and socialite. Work with the poor and play with the rich. You try to live in two worlds. Eventually you're gonna get your life ripped apart.
Tava só bicha. O Bies, seu filho da puta.
Caralho! Caralho, porra!
Hoje tudo é high-tech, Wi-Fi, internet, Bluetooth, 1000 graus, calor de proximidade. Rápido, porque tá diferente pra nós,
amigo. Passos had told me about this stuff. Oxidado. They called it rust, packed full of healthy ingredients like quicklime and kerosene, cheaper, stronger, and deadlier than crack. Easily marketed to the poor and desperate, all in all, a fine, honorable way to earn a living. I couldn't find any clues in this place, so I decided to do my bit for the drugs trade. That much security, it had to be Serrano's pad. Since I was in the neighborhood, I figured he wouldn't mind if I dropped in and thanked him personally for his hospitality. It wasn't like he wasn't expecting me. I had to hope the king was in his castle. As I approached the spot, I could hear raised voices.
Para de chorar!
Then I saw that Marcello had turned up with a suitcase full of money along with Fabiano's sister, Giovanna. I only understood a little, but things were not going well.
Não, rapaz, por favor!
I wasn't expecting quite so many armed goons, but there was no backing out now. I would just have to act harder than I felt.
Put the guns down! Let the girls go. No one needs to die, asshole.
Tomar no cu, seu gringo de merda. Vou matar...
Don't you kill her! Don't you!
Okay.
Caralho! Atividade! É a porra do Uber! Oh, você fica com o gringo! Atividade é muito tempo depois! Vamos nessa, caralho! Atividade! Atividade, caralho!
Baba! Meu filho da puta!
Here I was again, with all hell breaking loose around me, standing over another dead girl I had been trying to protect.
I'll give you a minute, buddy.
Thank you.
We'd only been married a short time. By now, she had been dead longer than I knew her. I still hadn't really forgiven myself for the Mona business, but I knew that was just grief. The insanity that comes with losing the life you had built. Michelle, I missed her with every part of my being. I hated the world for not killing me with her, and I hated myself for allowing this to happen to her and our little girl. But I knew I had to leave town.
Excuse me. Max Payne?
Somehow, I didn't think he was about to tell me I'd won the lottery.